Today is the Remembrance Day of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, our beloved leader and the most popular president that India has seen. At this occasion, my memories go back to 5 years on the same day. In the evening, around 7 o'clock, I was trying to call him on my mobile and wanted to invite him for a function at Thiruvananthapuram. The mobile reply was, "The person whom you are trying is not reachable." Well, it never occurred to me that he is not going to be reachable forever. Within an hour, I heard the sad news that our doctor, beloved Dr. Abdul Kalam, had passed away at Shillong while preparing to deliver a speech to the students of IIM Shillong. Well, as you are aware, that he was very passionate about interacting with the students and imparting the knowledge what he has gained to the next generation to enthuse them and groom them as a fine citizens of the globe. No wonder that he had his last breath while he was preparing his speech to the students of Indian Institute of Management at Shillong. Well, on a later occasion, I had the opportunity to go to Shillong, and they have taken me to the conference hall where Dr. Kalam would have given his speech. It is a hilly terrain, and this conference hall at a height nearly 3 stories tall, and we had to climb all the stairs to reach that place. Halfway through itself, I could feel the strain. Though I was 10 years younger to him, I can imagine what kind of stress that climb would have placed on his heart. He is not a person who takes rest. Though he would have felt some discomfort, he never bothered about it. He just sat down for a few minutes and then he said, "I'm ready." And he wanted his lieutenants to set up the PowerPoints and so on. And before he could catch the microphone and start his lecture, he collapsed. This is perhaps a very, very shocking news I had. And not only it has taken the entire country and many of the global leaders by surprise and sorrow. We have mourned his death, and I rushed to Rameshwaram the next day itself, and when his body arrived there on 29th of July, I was there to receive him. And well, his body was lying in state within the cold storage. Still, he was putting on an appearance of smiling face, and thought, I had imagined that he was telling me that, "Yes, my time has come. It is for you people to carry on my message. Yes, I do that mission even today." Next day, the old Rameshwaram turned to an ocean of people from all over the country. And it was a real unique funeral which is befitting and given to our great leader. My association with Dr. Kalam is for a period starting from the age of 24. In 1967, I joined him as a young engineer, and if at all I can claim somebody as my guru, it was Dr. Abdul Kalam. he had been the mentor, and he had been the guide, and he was a brotherly figure all these years. I learned all about rocketry, above all, the management of technology and people from him. It was a very unique style, which was not emulated, which was not there with any other scientist or any other leader in the country. No wonder he rose to the position of the President of India ultimately. We all recall his humble beginning at Rameswaram, his scanty childhood, where he had to sell newspapers for the livelihood, and very meager way he had to manage his studies in college as well as in the MIT. Afterwards, he was always wanted to do something innovative and new. No wonder Dr. Sarabhai has picked him as one of the pioneers in the space program, and he had made a great impact in the space program before leaving for DRDO. I was with him for the 18 years at ISRO, a close associate, and working together on many technology development problems. We had many successes, we have joyed over it. At the same time, there were several failures. Even the first SLV-3, what we launched, the first satellite launch vehicle, ended up in a failure. But he has taught us how not to get put off by failures, learn from failures, and use those lessons for the betterment of the product or the service, and ultimately reach the goal. Of course, he has been entrusted with a major responsibility of conceiving and implementing the integrated missile program in the country, and he had really accomplished that in with his all his skill, and transformed the entire defense research into a new productive and organization. Later, we have seen that he was also part of the team who have conceived and implemented the first atomic weapon, which was exploded by India. Thus he became not only the missile man, but also the father of atomic weapon in the country. After retirement as a scientific advisor, he has taken up education as his prime focus. He was working in the Anna University, and later, at that time, the government has selected him. Not government, all the parties together, I will say, it's the first opportunity in the history of India to have a technocrat for the president's post. On that post, he didn't make use of to enjoy the luxurious life in the palatial Rashtrapati Bhavan. He threw open the Rashtrapati Bhavan to the students, intellectuals, politicians, and representatives from all walks of life, and turned it to an open house that has attracted the attention not only in the country and everywhere outside also. His compassion to the poor and the downtrodden always was driving him to achieve programs which will benefit the people in the country. His contribution as a president are innumerable, and no wonder he has become the most popular president of India even today. Well, his loss, it is not only to his family, but also to the country and the globe as a whole. And I really have no words to express my sorrow and grief on this occasion. At the same time, I take this occasion to pray for the departed soul. And though he is physically not here, his spirit and his thoughts are influencing all of us to be a fine citizen of the globe and deliver the products and services which will improve the quality of life of the common man in the country.